Your SSB was from like start?
Yes. My SSB was on 12th of July, sir, of 2021. So I feel that the day before the SSB, that is 11th of July, is very important because this time, the day before, what I did was I did not study anything after 4 in the evening. By 4 in the evening, I finished off everything. And I went for a morning jog, evening jog in Mysore, because that was my first day in Mysore. So I wanted to acclimatize myself before the SSB because the weather is a bit different. So I went for a evening jog in the evening for 1.5 hours. And I went to the gym also to keep myself fit. And I had an early dinner by 7:30 so that the digestion process is good, and by 8:30 I had gone off to sleep. So I woke up in the on 12th of July, I woke up by 5:15 after a good night's sleep, because I feel a good night's sleep is very important for the screening process. And I reported to the center by 6:30 a.m. We were told to report by 7, so I reported 30 minutes prior to the reporting time. And then we had our documentation, the initial documentation regarding our AFCAT admit card and the COVID report. And then we were given breakfast at around 8 a.m. and our screening process started by 9 a.m. in the morning. I was allotted chest number 105. That was my initial chest number for the screening process. We had two sets of OIR, both comprising of 50 questions, and we were given 30 minutes to solve it. And this was back to back, like we don't get break in between. After one OIR, another OIR is immediately taken. And it is quite important that speed is maintained. And after the OIR test, I had practiced a lot of OIR before going to the SSB. So I was able to complete it well before the time which was allotted. And by 10, our OIR was completed and we were dispersed into two groups.
How useful was the OIR practices which we had carried out during our classes?
It was very useful, sir, because the OIR practice which was provided by you, that is a bit tough than which comes in the SSB. So you find it very easy when you're solving it in SSB, because if you have gone to a next higher level, then the level of questions which come in the SSB are very easy for you. So time wise also and difficulty wise also, I was well ahead, and I was able to complete it 5 minutes before itself, 5 or 7 minutes before. And difficulty also, I was not finding it much difficult, sir. And after that, after the OIR, we were split into two groups. One, the repeaters one, as I had already attended SSB before, so I was split into the repeater group. And the others, there was a fresher group. So what happened was, for freshers, they had the PPDT first and we were told to wait. Then then the repeaters were called and we were shown a PPDT image. What I felt was, in AFSB, the PPDT image is a bit hazy compared to the PPDT image which was shown in my previous SSB in Navy. The image was a bit hazy in AFSB, but we were able to make out that there were 5 people who were going out in a marketplace, and we were able to make story. So we had 1 minute to visualize. And 30 seconds to visualize, and then 1 minute to write the details of all the characters involved, the aim, and the story. And I think they give less than 4 minutes to write the story. I think they give only 3 minutes, and they do it wantedly. Sometimes even in OIR, what I have experienced is sometimes they say you have 30 minutes, but in 25 minutes itself, the time gets over. So these are things which one should not get surprised into, like as fast as possible you should try to do, because sometimes they try to build this pressure, keep how is the candidate reacting when the time is shortened. So always I feel ki it is better to keep the guard up and do things fastly, like not in a hasty way and get careless, but at the same time maintain that speed by not getting by not reducing the speed thinking that I have more time. And after that we had our PPDT. There were 10 people in my PPDT, and I felt the group was very cooperative. In PPDT I had the freedom, like they had given us the freedom to, if we were not able to complete the story which was in the written section, we can complete it while narrating. So I completed my story during the narration, and I did not fumble. I had made a story on an electric hybrid vehicle involving students of a college who have made an electric hybrid vehicle, and they are going to the market garage where
explain the picture again, like what you could see, how hazy it was.
Sir, the picture was very hazy. There were 4 to 5 characters involved, and they were going on a market road, and they were carrying something on top of their shoulder. Like all the 4 or 5 people involved, they were carrying some kind of a box on top of their shoulder. So initially I thought that it is a burial scene, but I didn't want to make a story which is very negative. So then, being an engineer, I improvised that thing can also be a chassis of a electric car which they are making. So then I made a positive story around an electric hybrid vehicle, that is a chassis which they are taking to the market, and they are taking suggestions from the garage workers ki how to make an electric hybrid vehicle, and with lithium batteries they make a vehicle which doesn't give pollution and reduces pollution in the society, incorporating the solar panels in it. So that was my story, and everyone had a good story. Some people had made stories on marathon, some had made a story on vaccination, some people had made story on awareness, social awareness. So as soon as the discussion started, I immediately came into the discussion, and I put in the initiative that why not make a story on social welfare, or for social welfare, because many people had made stories for social welfare. And when we were making common stories, some part of my story was also incorporated, some part of our 2-3 other member stories was also incorporated, and we had a final group story involving a robotic machine which will be giving vaccination to people and making them aware of it. And 3 out of the 10 people involved in the screening, 3 got screened in. So one was
what was their story also?
Sir,
who got screened in?
The both who got one person's story was regarding vaccination. His chest number was I think 98, and chest number 104, he had made a story regarding college farewell. Like he was organizing a college farewell, and my story was revolving around an electric hybrid vehicle. So 3 people, the one whom we had nominated to present the group story, he got screened in. Chest number 104 got screened in, and I got screened in. And whoever participated in the group discussion, they got screened in, who were able to like make an impact in the group discussion on the group. They screened them in. And I felt ki the screening group was very good. More people could have got screened in, but it's like, I don't know how they only took 3 more, because everyone was very cooperative. I felt ki we could have got more people screened in from our group. So screening, I felt, is very unpredictable. Like you have to keep your be very alert during screening.
This 3 is out of how many?
3 is out of 10, sir. Out of 10, they took only 3, sir.
Okay.
And they had called 155, sir. 155 people were called in the first day, and only 40 were screened in, sir. Remaining people had to leave the first day. And after I was screened in, immediately we were told to take our pens and come to the testing hall again, and then I think the time right now would have been around 2 in the afternoon, around 2, 2:10. So by that time, they again called in the testing room. And they told us to bring our pens. And then we were told to fill up PIQ forms, a form of indemnity and a PIQ form. And we had only 1 hour to fill this. So I carefully filled the PIQ form as to whatever I had done in my curriculum and whatever extracurricular activities which I had participated, I wrote those. And by 3:15, they left us. And in AFSB, they told that we have to again report in 6 in the evening for our psych test. So in AFSB, the psych test happened on the same day of the screening. So what I did was by 4:20, we were allotted rooms.
How many copies of PIQ form you had filled up?
I filled up 2 copies, sir. 2 copies of PIQ form.
And how about your self-description?
Self-description, like in psych test, we are told to fill, sir.
Okay, continue.
So by 4:20, we were allotted rooms and I was in group 3. That is, I was allotted chest number 25, which was group 3. So people from 24 to 31 were group 3. And I was allotted the Sukhoi squadron. There were many squadrons. Some were Rafale, some were Tejas, some were Sukhoi, some were Chinook. So I got into Sukhoi, and by the time I had reached my room, well, that is the dormitory, it was around 4:20. So for the psych test, what I did was I had taken some snacks with me, like protein bars and biscuits to keep my energy up. And snacks were also provided by Air Force. So I had they gave us a sandwich and tea. So I had sandwich, tea, and I had proper good amount of snacks to boost my energy, and I slept for a little while. Like, I slept off by 4:45 and I slept for around 45 to 50 minutes so that I am mentally alert for the psych test and well prepared for the psych test. And I kept myself mentally prepared ki kaise karna hai psych test ko. And before going to the psych test, I had a quick bath so that I feel fresh, so that I don't have any tiredness or fatigue. So I had a quick bath and I dressed up for the psych test, and by 6 p.m. we reported. And our psych test started at around 6:30 to 6:20. They started by
6:30 in the night.
Yes, sir. In the night, 6:30 it started, sir, on day one. And the psych tests were continuous, like TAT, VAT, SRT, SD. There was no break provided. It was continuous, like in Navy SSB, after our TAT and VAT, we get 10 minutes break. But in Air Force, they did not provide us any break. It was continuous till night 9 o'clock. So I feel ki jo that one day before, which the running which I had done, that I felt was very useful, because running made me fresh. So I did not get fatigued the next day. I was very fresh the whole day, and I was able to do the process very smoothly without any tiredness. Or some people were getting tired after the screening, but I was quite fresh the whole day. And by 9:10, the psych test got finished, and we were told ki we can have our dinner now. So psych test mein it was normal, sir. Like some tats to pictures were shown. Then there were words which we were supposed to write sentences on. And after that, we had our SRTs. So I was able to do 40 SRTs this time around. I was not, I was thinking a bit and then I was writing. Like in the previous SSB, I had completed 50 SRTs. But here I thought ki I will think a bit and then I will complete the SRT, because I did not want my logic to get disturbed. So I was thinking and I was doing, so I was able to complete 40 SRTs. And yes, sir.
How useful it was, the practice which you had carried out for on the spot TATs, VAT and SRT?
Yes, sir. So many images, which almost I think we had practiced 100 to 150 images, sir. And so many words and SRTs which we had practiced. So like it was the same, sir, almost the same images had come and the same VATs were coming. So the psych practice provided by you was very helpful, sir. It was very handy and it felt like nothing was new. Everything was just the like it was already I had done on stories on that. So I was very comfortable like attempting the psych test and the practice, and like you had told me the positive mindset which I had to maintain. Like if there is any person in uniform, I can make a positive story around it instead of going for something related to action or something. I can make it on some positive lines. So that knowledge was very useful, and the guidance provided ki how to attempt the psych test. That was very useful for me in doing the psych tests well. And the timed practice which you gave me was helpful to complete the test on time. Like in 4 minutes, I was able to write a story without overlapping the time.
Approximately how many words you could have written in 4 minutes?
4 minutes?
Approximately.
I think 15 seconds, like in 16.
What I mean to say, that the story which you wrote in 4 minutes, that could have been like around how many words? 80, 90, 100, like what was the approximate length?
Approximate length was 80 to 100 words, sir. Anything between 80 to 100 words. It did not exceed 100 words and it was not below 80 words.
Okay. Do you feel that you could have increased your speed slightly more to reach somewhere around 50 SRTs?
Yes, sir. I could have increased that speed, but that was a calculative decision which I took at that time.
Okay.
Because what I had noticed was if I had increased my speed, I felt that I did not want to make any mistake somewhere. Like some people are, they are able to do 55 SRTs all correct. But I wanted to like focus on the quality more this time around, sir.
Because okay. How about writing your self-description?
Self-description, sir, I was able to complete in 10 minutes, sir. Against the time of 15 which they had provided. I was able to, because I had practiced self-description before going to the SSB, like 2-3 times. And this self-description I was able to complete in 10 to 11 minutes. So I had 4 minutes of buffer.
You had filled up PIQ form 2 copies. And how many copies of self-description?
Self-description, 1 copy, sir.
Okay. Okay, sometimes students, they ask this type of question. So it is for their consumption.
Actually, self-description, they make a photocopy, sir. Like the dossier which we give, they make 2 to 3 photocopies and then they send it to the interviewing officer also, sir, before.
Okay, so your psych test is over. Now, next day.
Yes, sir. Next day, our GT, the GTO started, sir, the next day. The very first, we had GD. And the GD topic given to us was we were told to select between Make in India and I think river interlinking. I am not sure of the second topic which was given, but our group selected Make in India, and the topic was how will Make in India impact our country's progress. So the group discussion was revolving around that. So I made some good the blogs which were provided to you, which were provided by you to me, they were very helpful. And the facts which were provided by sir during the newspaper cuttings which we received. So I was able to make some valid points regarding the exports.
It means the slides, newspaper cuttings and other study material which was provided proved useful.
Yes, sir. The slides proved very useful, sir. Because Make in India, I think we had done a slide related to Make in India, sir. So that knowledge was very helpful in the group discussion. And group discussion, everyone wants to put in their points. So I feel it is necessary that at the we be cooperative at the same time a bit assertive so that we are also able to put in our points. So I was a bit assertive in the group discussion. I let others speak and at the same time I also speak my points which were there. And the group discussion lasted for around 15 minutes. After that, immediately the second group discussion started. In the second group discussion, the topic was artificial intelligence and the security threat which it, like what are the impact of artificial intelligence on our security systems. So I was following newspaper very sincerely and again the cuttings which were provided by sir on the WhatsApp platform were very useful because one cutting I remember regarding the Mumbai I think the Mumbai power cut which China had done on India with the help of artificial intelligence. So I was able to make that point in GD and even on Pakistan's information warfare which they do using artificial intelligence. So 2-3 points I was able to put in and the group was listening. So I feel that current affairs are very important. Like newspaper is something always we have to like read and it is very important to follow daily news because if we are able to put that daily news in that GD then it puts a positive impact on the GTO and on the group members also because they are listening to you because any knowledge which is related to current affairs everyone wants to listen and that was very means that was always provided by sir with the help of newspaper cuttings daily I received daily news from sir regarding the important current affairs which are happening so that guidance was very helpful in participating in the group discussion and
so yes. How you you really felt that the study material provided by Future Army Officer Academy was useful to you?
Yes sir, it was useful sir. Like we had so many slides and sessions and I will even in the interview it was very useful sir. I'll come to it when I'll start okay. About the interview.
Okay.
And yeah. So those slides information was very useful. Even river interlinking which we had talked about sir, we did not get the topic but the other group, the group one which had GT on another day, they got that topic of river interlinking for group discussion.
In fact, you were prepared for both.
I was prepared for both, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And even, yes, sir, Atmanirbhar Bharat was one topic which was given importance. Okay. So that was also discussed, sir, in the month of May, I remember.
Yeah, we discussed.
Yes, sir. So all those topics were very useful for GD. Even for lecturate, they were useful. And after GD, we had GPE, sir. In GPE also, I remember the very first class which I had with you in April. You had instructed me to sincerely write down the time and the distance required to reach from place A to place B. Like, be specific in my answers. And like those two to three GPEs which we had practiced, so that was very useful for me. So I was able to complete my solution in 10 minutes. Properly, I was able to complete my solution in 10 minutes. Like in the earlier SSB, which I had got conferenced out, I was not able to complete the solution. But in this SSB, I completed the solution in 10 minutes itself. And the 2 to 3 GPs which we had practiced, that was very useful, sir, to be logical and rational in the GPE task. And after we had, like, first the GTO briefed us on the map shown. He briefed us about the problem and then we were given 5 minutes to read and understand the problem. And then we got 10 minutes to write down the solution. And after 10 minutes, we were told to discuss. So in GPE, the discussion was very volatile. Like everyone was giving in different solutions, and it was sort of a fish market compared to the GDs. So here again, I accept, like, what I did was, if someone was giving a good point, I accepted his point. I was not, if his point was good, I accepted the point, and I just wanted to take the story, like the solution, forward. And if I had some good point, I just made that point. And whatever, like the chess number 20, I was chess number 25, and 26 had a very good point. So I took it, and even the group, they were taking in some of the good points. So it is important that whatever good points are there of other team members, we accept that instead of just saying our good points. So that was very useful. Like you had told me, sir, in during the GP practice, ki agar koi achha point bol raha hai, to usko accept karo. Aur apna point agar aapko thoda achha lag raha hai, to usko bhi bolo. So that was one thing which I did, sir. And after GP, the GP was again over in 15 minutes, sir. So this 45 minutes were very, very action packed, sir. Like it was one GD used to get over, another GD used to start, and it takes a lot of energy because everyone is very energetic during the discussions.
But I'm sure the group planning exercise, since you had an exposure to it, it would have certainly given you a good confidence.
Yes, sir. I was very confident this time around. And I think we had three GPs, sir, which were practiced. So yeah, that practice was very helpful in completing the solution on time, because once we completed the solution, the GTO was looking ki whether we have completed the solution or not. Like he was taking each solution, and then he was looking into each solution, and then he marked something. I don't know what GTO was marking, but he was looking into the solutions of everyone, and after that only he gave us the green signal to start the discussion.
Okay, the GP provided by Future Army Officer Academy proved useful to you.
Yes, sir. It was useful, sir. Quite useful, sir. Like the idea which was provided, ki jahan district administration ki madad leni hai, you take help of district administration. Jahan police ki madad leni hai, you take help of police. What resources which you feel can be used or can be imagined, those resources you need to imagine. So that was very helpful, sir.
How about lecturate?
Yes, sir. Lecturate, after this lecturate, like lecturate was very useful, sir. I had four topics. One was US-China relations. Then the other was Atmanirbhar Bharat. Then the third one was, I think, foreign direct investment. And the fourth topic, I am not remembering exactly what it was. But these were the three topics, and I spoke on US-China relations. I was comfortable in that topic, and I think I was able, like we had a slide on India-China relations and the geopolitics. So I was able to relate, and with the current affairs given to me, I was able to relate regarding the COVID situation, the Indian Ocean region, the string of pearls policy, and the influence of US on India's relations with China. So I related all three, and I presented a lecturate, and I was able to speak comfortably for 3 minutes without any problem. And once the GTO told 30 seconds left, I completed within the 30 seconds which were provided. And the overall, whatever the slides were provided during the classes, they were very useful, sir. Like we had slides related to India-China relation, India-US relation. So with that, I was able to correlate and put in a lecturate. I was able to correlate my knowledge, and I was able to put in a lecturate. And then we had those outdoor tasks involving PGT. So PGT, I felt ki AFSB ka thoda it is different compared to Army and Navy. Because in Navy, we use thoda ropes we use. In AFSB, it's like everything is direct. The plank, everything generally it gets done by direct bridging or double bridging. Thoda sa in PGT-3, thoda sa you have to make use of ropes. वहाँ पे भी जस्ट वो कैंटिलीवर का कॉन्सेप्ट ही काम आ रहा था where in we had to see where the fulcrum is and where the support is. But overall it was very easy compared to the SSBs in army, where the GTOs in SSB, like the grounds of PGT and HGT, I felt they are very somewhat of a higher level in Navy or Army, but in FSB I felt it was thoda easy.
Okay. Maybe since by now you had gained a lot of confidence, even the difficult things also appear to be easy. Yeah. Yes. And when things become tough, it is the tougher who gets going.
Like it's the guidance are provided by you, like the knowledge which you gave on fulcrum and support. So that was useful, sir, to tackle the obstacles.
Okay. So what was the difficulty you felt in progressive group tasks? You said it is different from Navy and Army.
Sir, difficulty which I felt was actually pehle obstacle mein thoda mere ko time laga samajhne mein ki yahan pe zyada tar cheeze they are being done in a simple way. Like I was looking for complex ideas, but things were being done in a very simple way. So I understood ki here I have to think of a simple solution involving direct bridging or double bridging. And even in PGT-3, I need to just look into the support and fulcrum, because rope was not getting used much. So that was the change I made after PGT-1. So then I started looking for simple solutions, and I was able to contribute to the group in a very positive way. And it's like I thought this as a game. Like,
so the lesson learned is don't look for complex things. Think for people. It is the candidate who makes it complex.
Yes sir. It is actually very easy, but when we start looking for complex solutions, then we don't get ideas, sir. But when we think in a simple way, ki direct, how simple. Jitta simple we keep it, it is very easy, sir. So that was one thing which I made the change after my first PGT, sir. So in PGT 2 and 3, I was able to contribute, sir, effectively. And in Mysore...
How tired you were after second or third obstacle?
After third obstacle, thoda it was... It was not tiring, sir, actually, because in Mysore, it was raining continuously. So our PGT, like when we were doing the GTO, it was raining. And only problem which I was facing was, like, because of the rain, the balli and patta had become very slippery. So at some places, we had to walk on the this balli instead of the plank. So that was getting a bit difficult because of the rain. So it was because mud was there on the shoe, and already people had walked on the balli, so it was getting a bit slippery. Otherwise, it was fine, sir. And here we also got the time to do the PGT 4, sir. Like generally PGT 3 tak Navy mein PGT 3 tak hi we went. Here the GTO also told us to do PGT 4. PGT 4.
This group was cooperative.
Yes, sir. Group was very cooperative, sir. Everyone was like, if someone had a good idea, we incorporated that good idea. And
you got a chance to lift some of the loads?
Yes, sir. Some places I was lifting the load also, sir.
Okay.
And it was not like only one person is lifting the load, sir. Ki ek banda hai, he's the one who is lifting the load and coming, and others are not doing that. Everyone was lifting the load in a like collective way. Some places.
Few odd people must be there who may not be interested in lifting the load.
Actually,
were there any?
No, sir. In this group, actually, everyone wanted to lift the load, sir. Like,
okay. It was a positive group.
Yes, sir. It was a positive group and a very cooperative group. So things went very smoothly, sir. in PGT. And after PGT, we had a gap, like the GTO gave us a break, and we had our snacks during that break. And
how much time was taken during PGT?
PGT around 45 minutes, sir. 45 minutes.
And you people could do even the fourth obstacle also?
Yes, sir. Fourth obstacle also we were able to do, sir.
I hope people were using parliamentary language.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Everyone was using parliamentary, like very, very supportive group, sir.
Yeah, sometimes there's a tiff, people start using unparliamentary language. I hope there was no other grouping out there. People from different area or different school or different town getting together and not listening to others. I hope it was not there.
No, sir. It was not there, sir.
Okay, very nice. It was a good group.
Yes.
Go ahead.
So after the fourth obstacle, the GTO gave us only one mistake we did, sir, as a group, that the GTO pointed out during the PGT3. PGT3, what happened was there was a structure like this. There were two poles and there was a support in front. So what we had done was we had put the plank in on the support and we were using the rope as the fulcrum. So after two people had gone over, what had happened was the rope had come down, and we did not notice that the rope had come down and the plank was becoming very steep and inclined. So like three people were remaining and I was one of them. So I slipped when I was going over. I slipped. So again I came and again I bent, and the next person who came after me, he also slipped. So then the GTO he told us ki yahan pe, see, you're making a mistake ki the rope has come down and you have not observed it. It has come down. So that is where we were pointed ki rope, we need to be careful about the rope. So that was one mistake which we did, sir, in PGT3. Otherwise everything went very smoothly, sir. And after the fourth obstacle, we had a break, sir, and it was a 15 minute break, and then we were again told to come back, and we had our HGT, sir. So in chess number wise, the GTO split us like 25 to 28 were one group, 24 to 27 were one group, and 28 to 31 was the second group. And HGT was also very simple, sir. It was over in around 5 minutes.
Yes, 5 minutes.
Yes, sir. In 5 minutes, it was over, sir. HGT.
Okay. What was the difference like here? The PGT, HGT, they are the leaderless exercises. But yes, how you could come ahead and took over as a leader out here?
Sir, actually, after the PGT, I had developed a very good sense of idea ki how things are being done. So in HGT, immediately I was giving the idea, and aisa nahi tha ki just idea dena hai. After giving the idea, it is important to implement it also. So it is not seen ki he's only speaking but not doing the task. So immediately after giving the idea, we used to see whether it's workable. And if it's workable, then we used to go forward. So if suppose one person is giving an idea, so we used to work it out. If it's not working, then again, I used to give some good idea, or some other group member used to give in some good idea. And we progressed further like that, sir. Only thing was, it was raining a lot, sir, and winds were blowing. So thoda at times, rain or wind mein thoda it come, kahin bar it becomes a bit difficult to...
Would you like to suggest that what kind of shoes one should have, especially during the rainy season? Any particular thing you want to recommend on this end?
Yes, sir. I personally bought new set of shoes, sir, after the AFSB, because my shoes were slipping. So my shoes did not have treads on it. They were plain, sir. So I think for any SSB, it is important to have shoes which are having treadings on it,
so that it can make some grip.
Yeah, it can make some grip. So that was one part which I should have focused on. Though I was able to manage it, but after my SSB, I bought a new set of shoes so that it doesn't happen again.
Okay, so your half group task, how it started?
Sir, some people wanted to go on the left, some people wanted to go on right. So first we tried out the way which is on the right. It didn't
work out. How many people were there in this half group?
Four people were there, sir. Four people.
Okay.
So on the left side, on the right side, it didn't work out. So then we went on the left side, and then it worked out. So we, one part of the team went this way, and then straight ahead there was I don't remember exactly, but there was I think a bench, and everything was direct bridging, sir. Matlab,
okay. It was happening the way you people desired.
Yes, sir. It was easy, sir. Actually, if in AFSB, it's like if you think it in a simple way, it gets done very fastly. Because most of the things are direct bridging hoti hai, sir. So direct bridging or double bridging mein task is getting completed, sir. Sometimes we think it is more than 4 feet, but when we put the plank or balli, we are able to see that it is directly it is getting bridged. So that was one thing which we were alert to see whether 4 feet ke andar hai, we can do it in that way.
Okay.
And after the HGT, we had our lecturate, sir. Actually, after the HGT, we had our lecturate, and some of the topics which had come during the lecturate were borderless words, fiscal deficit, then world powers, like which the other members who had selected.
What is borderless? What you said?
Right now we live in a world which is having borders, sir. International borders.
Okay, borderless world.
Yes, sir. Borderless world.
Okay, continue.
One of them had fiscal deficit as the topic. Another had importance of social media and news media in a democracy. I took Indo-China relations.
Indo-China or US-China relations?
Sorry, US-China, sir. US-China relations. US-China relations. And one more person, he had the topic world as a superpower. So mostly the topics were related to geopolitics, sir. Quite related to geopolitics. And after the lecturate, the GTO gave and the GTO came and I don't know why GTO told us in the briefing after the lecturate, okay, gentlemen, you did well, and I hope you learn from your mistakes of today. So I think kahin na kahin we made some mistakes as a group. So he told us indirectly ki you learn from the mistakes which you made today and do it in a better way tomorrow. So after the GTO's briefing, some people, I think on day two, no one had interviews from our group. So we were free after the GTOs on day two, and on day two we were briefed upon the interview schedule, almost 4 or 5 of us had interviews the next day, that is day three. So as soon as the day two got over, on day three the GTO started again, and initially in the morning I was told that I'll be having my interview at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So on day three, the first, so I was mentally prepared for the interview also, because after GTO, soon I had to go for interview without any gap. So the first task of GTO on day three was command task. So command task, everyone had different, different tasks. No person got, only two of us got one task, and each task had its like difficulty, and it was not like some people got easy tasks, some people got tough tasks. Everyone was having a moderate amount of difficulties during the command task. And during my command task, what I had like the advice which you had given me was to be assertive, sir, during the command task. And if the GTO is kuch bol raha hai, if he's trying to intimidate you or anything, not get bothered with it. So I was assertive, sir, during the command task. And initially, like in the command task, there was the GTO had a small talk with me before the command task.
Firstly, how you carried out the selection of the two person who were supposed to assist you during in the command task? What was your parameters of your selecting those chaps?
Sir, I selected my group members on two parameters, sir. I judged how the other person had performed in his PGT and HGT. So the person who had performed well in PGT, HGT, I took him. And the second thing which I took into account was his weight and height. Like if he's thin, if he's lean, and if his height is good, and if he's good in tying knots. So that was the kind of person which I took as my group member, so that we can easily go from one place to another without any problem. So that was one thing which I focused on, ki who is lean, who is fit, and who was good during the PGT and HGT, and who is good with the knots, so that if I say him to tie any knots, he's able to do that.
And were they cooperative?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Very cooperative, sir.
Okay. Then what GTO discussed with you? How he briefed you?
Yes, sir. Before the command task, the GTO asked me about my parents, sir. From the place from where I'm coming. He asked me my AFCAT and EKT marks. Then he asked me my graduation marks. Then he asked me about my brother, ki what he's doing, where he's posted currently. Then he asked me ki when I had given the SSB previously. And he asked me ki what change I made from the previous SSB to this SSB. Like he asked ki what have you changed, like you he asked me when I had given the previous SSB. So I told April. So then he was like, okay, you have given it recently, so what changes have you made in the past 2 months? These were some of the questions which he asked me. And after asking these questions, he told me, okay, Spandan,
what was your reply to this particular question? What all changes you have made?
What all changes? I told, sir, ki I have worked hard, and I have worked hard on my fitness, and with the I have worked hard on my current affairs, and with the guidance of trainers, I have come and I have prepared. And I told him ki this time I'm well prepared. Like I told, I was
last time you had suffered with COVID.
Yes,
and you were physically you had gone weak.
Yes, sir.
And you were feeling quite quite weak because,
yes,
of that. You could have mentioned that. Yes.
Yes, sir. I mentioned it, sir. I mentioned it. I told him ki sir, previous, like when he was asking me about the previous attempts which I had made, I told him ki sir, the attempt which I made in the month of May, I was having COVID, so I was not able. He had asked me about it also, so I told him ki sir, I was having COVID, and I was not able to perform well in the screening due to the fatigue and breathlessness. So he was like, okay. He didn't pay much attention to it from what I observed. Like he was like, okay, that's fine. Though I mentioned it, I mentioned ki I had COVID in the month of May. And after that, he asked me my graduation marks, ki so how much have you scored? So I told, I have scored 93.5%. So he was like, so that is a good score. And then one thing which I noticed was I had come from Chennai, and repeatedly the GTO was asking me, so you have come from Bhopal. How did you come from Bhopal? Though he knew that I'm from Chennai, but I told him the first answer itself. I told ki, no, sir, I've come from Chennai. And again, he asked me, ki, so from Bhopal, how have you come? So both the times I had to correct him. No, sir, I've come from Chennai and I've come on a plane. So
he must be actually checking your courage of conviction, whether you can put it correctly or not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So that was two times he did it, sir. So both the times I had to tell him, ki, no, sir, I have come from Chennai on a plane. I had come to Bangalore and then I have come to Mysore. So, and one more thing which he was checking my awareness, ki, how much I know about my parents, about my brother.
What was the question? How he asked?
He asked me, ki, what does my father do? Exactly, what is his role in the nuclear power plant which my father is working in? And he asked me, ki, what my brother is doing right now, what is his role, where is he currently posted and what is he doing. So thoda he was it is like a mini interview of the GTO which he does before the GTO, just to I don't know, but some kind of a mini interview which he asked every candidate these questions.
What he asked about your parents?
He asked, ki, how have your parents guided you?
Okay.
And these were the set of questions which he had asked. He asked me what I am doing right now.
Okay. Yeah, what was your answer?
Sir, I told, ki, I have right now completed my graduation degree from Manipal and recently completed, and I was preparing for SSB and I have come. So I told him an answer in that way, ki, recently I have passed out in the month of June.
Okay. So how you continued your command task?
So then he asked me, ki, which two chess numbers you want. So I called in chess number 31 and 29. And 31 was a candidate. He was an ex-serviceman of Navy. So he was quite fit.
He cannot be ex-serviceman. He must be a serving personnel.
He was a serving petty officer, sir.
Okay.
So I called him, and one of other was chess number 29.
Okay.
And I was given a task where there was a circle and in the center there was a bomb. So I was to take the bomb with my group and bring the bomb back. And the bomb was in a kind of a red color circle which cannot be touched, and that bomb had to be taken in 15 minutes. So I briefed my the subordinates, ki, okay, today I am your commander and this is the task provided by the GTO to us, and I'll be commanding you to take the bomb from the position which it is in and safely defuse it and get it back from the circumference line. And initially I observed the command task which was given, and I thought of the ground extension. My first idea which I thought out was, ki, I will put in a plank, two people will be standing on the plank, I will take the bully and I'll take out the bomb. Then this was one mistake which I, this was a, this was, I was thinking in the right way, but I made a mistake here by thinking that I cannot use the bully to take the bomb. This was one mistake I made, because I executed this idea, but midway I thought ki I'm violating the rules. Kyunki if I can take anything with bully or plank, then it is very easy ki main seedhe bully dal ke bomb ko le lu. But actually I was thinking in the right direction. Midway I stopped that. So I shouldn't have stopped. So what I would suggest everyone is ki kuch idea if you are getting, do it completely instead of thinking ki whether it is right or wrong. So that was one mistake which I made in the command task. And luckily my mind was working. So after this was not this was after this I went and I observed ki there are two poles like this. So then I told my subordinates to tie a rope over the pole, and then we can put the plank over it, and one fellow can stand from behind, and then we can take the bomb. So this was my second idea, and this time the GTO was like, okay, this will work. So he was like, okay, this will work. You don't need to like show it exactly. This will work. I'm satisfied. And after that, he left us. So I was able to, actually there were two to three ways. We were discussing the command task. So the first way which I had thought, my groupmate, he told me that I should have executed that. So what I felt was that was one mistake which I could have avoided in command task.
Okay. It was lucky that you could complete from other end.
हाँ, it was lucky कि I got a second idea कि ऐसा हो सकता है कि we can
that too well within time.
Yes, sir.
Your execution was accepted. Otherwise, sometime you may end up in trouble also.
Yes, sir. And I got the second idea with only 2 to 3 minutes left, sir.
So how much time he gave you for your command task?
He gave me 15 minutes, sir. Okay. He gave me 15 minutes and. When the first idea did not work out, I was like, यार कैसे होगा ये task? क्योंकि दो पोल हैं और कुछ है नहीं सिर्फ सामने की तरफ, सिर्फ दो पोल हैं एंड बाहर से यू कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. तो व्हेन इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट कि व्हेन यू आर नॉट गेटिंग एन आइडिया कि यू जस्ट गो अराउंड द, मतलब देर इज अ सर्कल, सो आई वेंट अराउंड द क्लॉक, अराउंड द सर्कल एंड देन आई सॉ कि टू पोल्स हैं. So then I got the idea immediately ki I can use the poles which are there in the command task. So that was one thing which helped me. And after the command task, I was again like I had to again go because I was also called. So in that there was a different structure, and it is important ki when you are called, you don't give any suggestion to the person who is doing the task, because the GTO had told that if you give suggestions, that will go against you. So I was like, whatever the commander told me, I did that, and did not give any suggestions from my side.
How many people called you?
Two people called me, sir.
Out of?
We were around 7 or 8, sir. Actually, the limit was 2, more than 2, because structures are limited. 4 or 5 are there. So, agar wo sabko bula lenge, to then dikh jayega sir, pura sabko.
Okay, okay. Still, 2 called you. You yourself were third one out of 7 or 8. 3 is okay, good ratio.
Yes, sir. Yes. And
there must be some people whom nobody would have called.
No, sir. We like at the end we ensured that everyone gets at least called once. Matlab, at the end who were not called, we told ki let us call them also, let us give them also an opportunity. It should not happen ki in our group people are left out. Okay. So at the end we made a decision to give them the chance, sir.
Okay, it means people discuss this.
Yes, sir. People discuss this, sir. Everyone knows ki जितने बार आपको बुलाया जाएगा, it is a, मतलब it is seen in a good way, ki is being called many times.
Okay, good. So you could, your idea strikes, though it was in the last few minutes.
Yes, sir.
But you could score few sixes.
Yes, sir. In the last minute, it worked, sir.
Okay.
Otherwise, it was
okay.
Getting difficult, sir.
Happily, your GTO task was over.
Yes, sir. We had two more tasks, sir. One was individual obstacle. So, individual obstacle, I feel compared to Navy or Army, it is quite tough, sir. Air Force ka, because in Army, like the rope for this Tiger Leap, it is very near. Like you have to just jump and catch the rope. But in Air Force, they keep the rope very far. Like there's a distance between the place from where you're standing and from where the rope is.
Okay. How far it could be? 3 feet? 4 feet?
Yes, sir. It could be easily 3 feet, sir.
Maybe more than that. 4 around.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And even the structures are at a very higher height, sir. Like when I had gone to Navy, the structures were not of much height. But in Air Force, the height of the structure is very, like, more than the one which are done at Navy and Army.
Slightly, you are tested against the height.
Yes, sir. Tested against the height. So much tested against the height, sir. Even the double jump which we have to do, in Army, it is like you go to the top and the second jump which you have to make, it is perfectly aligned with this one, the first one, sir. Only slightly it is ahead of this one. So you don't need to think much. You just go up and come down. In Air Force, it is like the first one is here and the second one is here, sir. So
there's a gap, sir.
So they like they have a very huge gap, and they want you to like feel that ki height se to dar nahi lag raha, if anyone is not scared of heights or something like that. And even the Burma Bridge, like in Army it is like you can, in Navy which I had gone, one side you can go up, you can climb, and the second side you can just come down by catching hold of a rope, or you can even jump. But in Air Force, they don't give you that freedom. It is like you have to climb, like there's a pole, you have to climb the pole, and when you go that side, you have to come down using the pole only. If you jump, then that is not counted as you did it. And even the overhanging beam, in Army, you can just go run over the beam and jump. But in Air Force, it is like you have to climb the pole, go, then you have to again come down using the pole. So it gets very difficult to come down with the pole after you have crossed at the end. And with rain and everything around, it only makes a thing more difficult to do.
How was vertical rope there?
Vertical rope which you have to climb, sir?
Yeah.
It was good, sir. Though it was raining, so it had become very slippery. But
what would be the height?
Height would be around, I'm not sure, sir. Around
15 feet?
Not sure, sir, how much. But it was there, sir. Matlab, kafi height mein tha.
And because of rain, it was slightly slippery also.
It was slightly slippery, sir.
You had to really make an effort to
complete. Yes, sir. Really, Air Force individual obstacles are very tough, sir, compared to Army or Navy. Army or Navy, if even some, like I was not much fit, but still I was able to do 7 in Navy. But with that much amount of fitness, you cannot handle Air Force obstacles, sir. Because arm strength, they check a lot. And even this height thing be, they check a lot, sir.
Okay. There must be people who must be getting slipped down or got injuries.
Yes, sir. Some people, they did not get injuries, but like people were very smart. So what they did was, where there was a chance of injury, they did it later. What do you recommend?
One should do in sequence?
Better to do in sequence, sir. Jo clockwise or anti-clock, either you do clockwise or you do anti-clockwise, sir. Any sequence which you are comfortable with.
Okay, that's nice. Okay, after the individual obstacle, then interview.
Then the final group task, sir.
Fine, okay.
Before the final group task, the GTO came and told us ki I have seen your performance. He was very assertive and he told, I have seen your performance. And now in the conference, you can be sure that I will put in a voice for you. He told us this, sir. And he told that now it is your final group task. So you give it your best. So we did our...
He was trying to motivate you people.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He was trying to motivate ki conference mein I'll be with you guys. Yeah, something like that. He was trying to motivate, sir. And then he was a nice, like nice person, sir. So GTO tasks were quite good, sir. And then we had the final group task. And after final group task...
how much time was given for final group task?
Final group task also, it took 10 minutes, sir. Like, or he was like, when I had gone for Navy, I saw that final group task, it was not taken much seriously. Like, it was like, you can do it. But here, even in final group task, he was giving points and he was noting everything down, sir.
How was the obstacle of the final group task?
It was of PGT 3 level, sir. PGT 3 level.
Okay. And time given at 5 to 10 minutes?
Yes, sir. 10 minutes he gave, sir. But after he had got the idea, then he told, after I think around 8 minutes, when he had got what the group is doing idea, then he left us, sir.
Okay.
So
fine. Now tell about your interview.
Yes, sir. By 11 o'clock, the GT had completed.
This is the fourth day you were talking.
This is day 3, sir. Day 3.
Okay.
Day 4, we did not have anything, sir. Day 3 itself, it got completed.
Okay. Okay. Nice.
So, day 3, at 11 o'clock, we reached, sir, around our rooms. And I was informed ki mera interview, it has got changed. Earlier, it was 1:30. So now they told ki now it will be 3:30. So I got ample amount of time, sir. So I did not read anything, sir, in between the interview. Only thing which I did was I went to a motivation room. There's a motivation room which is kept. So there are generally newspapers come, sir. So I just went and read the past 2-3 days newspaper, whatever is there before the interview, so that because I had written reading newspaper in my PIQ, so I did not want to get surprised if he asked me any question related to current affairs. So I just read the past 2-3 days newspaper, and I had my lunch, and we were supposed to report at 3 o'clock in the waiting room. I went there by 2:30 itself, sir. So I was 1 hour before itself I had reported there. So I was resting in the waiting room, and I was quite relaxed, and I was reading the newspaper which was kept in the waiting room. And in Air Force they tell us to bring all the certificates and mark sheets, all the things which we have written in the PIQ, whatever we are having, all those documents, our 10th, 12th graduation mark sheets, everything they tell to bring. So we had that. I had made that booklet of it, and around 3:15 the interviewing officer asked for my booklet, and he went through my booklet for around 10 minutes, and by 3:30 I went for the interview. So in the interview, initially he told me ki told me to remove my mask, and he was very friendly. The deputy president of the board was taking my interview, and he asked me whether I want to keep my mask on. Like, there's another table which is kept beside, and he gave me an option of removing my mask and keeping it there, or I can just keep my mask down. So initially I thought of keeping it down, but then N95 mask, that string is there, so that comes in the ear. So I thought ki it is better, it will not come in the ear, so I put it on the table. So he was like, it feels good without the mask. He was asking questions like that. So I happily told, yes sir, thoda comfortable hai without the mask. Though the shield was on, always we are supposed to keep the shield. and
shield was with you when even you were doing individual obstacles?
No, sir. That time we can remove our shield, sir.
Okay.
And in the interview, as soon as you go, they tell ki whenever you want to have water, you can have a water, because they keep this glass of water. Though my father had advised me ki never have a glass of water during the interview, kyunki it may send a mixed signal ki you're under pressure or you are not feeling comfortable. So generally I have enough water before the interview, and I don't take any water during the interview which is provided in the glass. And interview was very good,
sir. Say again, what was there in the glass?
Like, there's a glass of water, sir, which is kept, and before
glass
the
water.
Yes, sir, there's a glass of water which they keep, and the interviewing officer, he says ki you can have this glass of water whenever you want it, ki whenever during the conversation you can have this glass of water whenever you are thirsty. So my father had advised me, and even I feel ki it is better not to have that glass of water during the interview, because it can give a mixed reaction that the candidate is under stress, so he is having water or something like that. So I generally have enough water before the interview, and I don't take the glass of water which is provided. That is my way of like thinking, sir.
Okay. So how interview started?
Interview started with rapid fire, sir. Like, before the rapid fire, he asked me about the place. He asked me ki I think my interviewing officer was from Tamil Nadu only, and he was a native of Tamil Nadu, and I was also coming from Tamil Nadu. So he wanted to know whether I have any bias towards Tamil speaking people, me being a North Indian. So he put in a question asking me what is your opinion about people of Tamil Nadu? Do you think they follow rules and regulations, and their behavior is good? That was the first question which he asked me. So I told generally, like, I have seen that yes, sir, people of Tamil Nadu, they follow rules and regulations, and they are very good in their behavior. So that was my answer to his question, and
it was a pleasing answer to the presiding officer, the interviewing officer.
Yes sir, he was very happy listening that answer, sir. He was laughing and smiling, and so I was able to make out,
he could understand that you are so smart.
So
you said what he wanted to listen.
Yes sir, he was from Tamil Nadu only, sir. So I knew that he will ask some, like, I knew they ask questions related to place. As you had told, sir, ki in my preparation for interview, know about your place well.
Correct.
From where you are going. So I was prepared, but it so happened that the interviewing officer was also from Tamil Nadu, and he just wanted to know ki how I feel about that place. And then he asked me about the government which has come, like the DMK government, the Stalin government which has come. So he asked, how is the government? Is it functioning well? Is it doing its tasks well? So I told, replied in a positive way, ki yes, everything is going on well, and the government is doing its best. Then after that, he started with the rapid fire, sir. He asked me about the place where I come from. In sequence, his sequence was, tell me more about the place where you come from. What does your father and mother do? Tell me all about your academics, which you have pursued till your graduation, the extracurricular activities which you have participated, tell me about your friends and the hobbies which you have, and also tell me the position of responsibilities which you have kept, like all during your academic academics. So he asked me a barrage of like he was very gentle, but at the same time he used to like some interviewing of in Navy. The interviewing officer was very strict. Like there were two interviewing officers, one was strict and one was sweet. But here there was only one interviewing officer, and even if he used to like hit me, he used to hit it very sweetly. He asked me ki, like he had a very good idea about me well before the interview. Only one thing he wanted to like which he really had was he was impressed with my academic performance, but he wanted to know ki in college why I did not indulge in team game. Like I used to do running and jogging, so he asked me in a very okay Spandan, I can understand that you have been a very good student and academically you have been very sound, but why college is a place where so much freedom is given? You could have played a team game there, so that means your friends were better time managers than you. He put in a question like that, ki he wanted to know whether I am getting irritated when my friends are kept above me. So he whatever he did it in a very sweet way. So my answer to that question was ki sir, yes, I did not play any team games, but whatever projects which I did, like team in team games we develop teamwork and cooperation. So whatever that teamwork and cooperation is there, that I have done in my projects which I have done, and being a COVID scenario, in college generally what happens is as a junior you don't get much to play team games. As you enter your third year, you get an opportunity to play more team games. So I explained to him that as soon as I entered my third year, it also happened that college got wiped out due to the COVID situation. So that was one thing which I feel I should have covered, ki I should have done that, because
Please continue.
Yes, sir. That was one thing which I feel I could have done more in my college. Genuinely, like I could have played one or two more. Generally, we play cricket. I used to play cricket in my college also, but I didn't represent my college. So I could have put in that I have played team games in college also with my friends. But that is one trick which I missed. That is something which I have actually done. Which I should have put.
You could not play the games during college time.
Like I did not represent my college, but it was never that I did not play cricket in my college. I used to play cricket.
You could not put across that point.
Yeah, I should have put across that point, sir. Though it did not go against me, because I was able to convince. Because then he gave me a situation. He asked me ki jaise projects hota hai, whatever projects you have done. He gave me 2 to 3 situations ki how did you manage when one or two people were not listening to you, or there were, as you are doing a team project, there may be conflicts which are coming. So how did you resolve those conflicts? Then he asked me how, because I was the team leader of a project which I had done. So he asked me how I had led the team. So I gave very good answers there. So he was very satisfied with my answers, which I had done in the role of a team leader as a project of my college. So that was one thing which he grilled, and I was able to answer very effectively there. And he was, for everything he was asking examples, which I was able
like,
to give.
Like what examples? Yes.
Like he asked ki. Say 2 people you told were not listening. So give me an example, like how you resolved the matter. As an ki 2 people were not listening, what you did? He was asking in detail ki which topic was it of the college project which they were not listening to, what was the situation, how did you manage. So everything was going, he was going in detail. And so one aspect was focused on my project which I had done. So he asked me a situation where no one was listening to me. So I told ki there is a topic of eutectics which no one is willing to do. So it being a tough topic, as a team leader, I took on the responsibility to do it. And being a team leader, I distributed the work in such a way that no one gets overloaded, because people were from all three sections. Like, there were three sections in our college, and each one follows different schedule and different timetable. So I looked into the timetable and gave the work accordingly. And he asked me a situation in the team project where some of the team members are not, like, there may be a situation where you tell someone something and they don't listen. So how do you react to it? So some part of the interview was focused on that, and I had done.
Could you amplify your last point?
Which point, sir? Like, yes, sir. So we have a project, sir, in that. So he asked me, ki when you tell someone to do something in a way and they don't do it that way, so how do you react? Like, how do you manage things with him? So he told me, give me a situation where something happened like this in your project. So I told him, ki sir, our project was a research project. So whenever we give work to anyone, there are chances of plagiarism. Like, he will read from Wikipedia or from different sources, and then he's supposed to write a research paper, and then it is checked for plagiarism. So generally, plagiarism till 20% is accepted. So as a team leader, I am supposed to check whether the plagiarism is crossing 20% or not. So in some cases, when it crosses 20%, I have to convince the team member ki his work is good, but it needs, because plagiarism is something which, even for small words like is and or, it catches it and it makes it look like it's plagiarized, even though the candidate has worked and he has put in his own report. So I have to convince him in a very soft way ki, you know, thoda yahan pe aap aur thoda kaam kar sakte ho, thoda ye dekh sakte ho. So that I told him, so he was happy ki I have dealt with the situation in a very soft way, instead of like telling him ki no, ye aisa nahi hona chahiye, wo waisa nahi hona chahiye. Then so that was one thing where he was asking a lot about my team projects and how I worked with them. Then one more situation which he asked was whether there was any situation in which no one was listening to you. So it had happened ki there is a topic, eutectics, which is tough, like which you don't find material to work on it in the internet. So my father, being a research scientist, I took on that topic as no one was able to do it. So I took that topic, and I, with the help of my father, I completed that topic.
What is the topic? Just repeat.
That was eutectics, sir. There is a, like,
how you spell it?
EU.
EU.
TEC. TICS.
TECTI.
Eutectics. Like, yes, it is related to thermal energy storage, sir. Phase change materials.
Okay, it is good for the listener. They'll be listening a new thing. Thermal energy.
Thermal energy storage, sir. It is like engineering topic, sir.
Okay, and on these such topic, you don't find material.
Yes, sir. At times we don't find material, sir, because jo research paper hai, they are very limited, sir.
And maybe kept secret also.
Yes, sir. Actually, this is a project which is done in labs, sir. It is not to be done in home. But due to COVID, we are not you are not able to go to labs of college. So then you have to do the project. So you have to see other people's research paper. So, wo thoda ho jata hai, sir, kahin par.
So he asked you question on this.
Haan, he asked me question on my project, sir. He asked many questions related to my project and on situations ki kaise karna hai, kya karna hai. Okay. Then after that, he asked me many questions related to my mother and father, sir.
Like
what are they doing, what are the changes you want in them, and what changes they want in you.
Okay, it is all good qualities of your parents and bad qualities of parents, and what are your bad qualities your parents feel, and what are your good qualities?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Putting indirect way.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Then he asked, who is your best friend? And if I call your best friend here, what will be the two things which he will say about you to me? This was one question which he had given. Then he asked what my friends are doing right now. And then he asked me, ki, your friends are preparing for so many competitive exams. Like some of my friends are preparing for UPSC. Some are preparing for GATE. So he told me, why not you also prepare for those competitive exams? Like that, he was putting situations. And then he was asking me my plan B, backup plan, all that he was asking, sir.
How he asked you about your backup plan?
He indirectly asked me, ki, what are exams you have given in your graduation?
Okay.
And then he asked, ki, okay, so other than defense, you have not given any other exam. So what is your backup plan? Then he asked me that, sir.
It is a, you can say, a version of like, when they say, if you are not selected in defense, what you will do?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Basically, it has come out from that point.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So one should be mentally prepared for such questions. So directly or indirectly, they will ask you.
So he was asking that, sir. And then he asked me, he asked me more about my friends, sir. How do I spend time with my friends? And the whole interview was focused on my friends, my parents, and me, sir. Like, the whole interview was focused on that, sir. Ki friends ka kya hai tumhara opinion, tumhara kya hai friends ke bare mein opinion. Like, he had entered the full domain of this friends, family, and brother, sir. And then teachers, sir. Ki kaun se teachers, which teachers you like and which teachers you don't like. That was one question which he asked. And I can remember these were some of the questions which he...
Anything he asked about your games and sports or your hobbies?
Hobbies, he did not ask even one question, sir. About games and sports, he asked, like, how did you play cricket? Regarding cricket, he asked some questions, sir. Who is your favorite player? And why do you like cricket? These were some questions he asked, sir, related to cricket.
How long your interview lasted?
My interview lasted for more than 1 hour, sir.
Okay. You were energetic or nervous?
Initially, in the initial 10 minutes, I was a bit nervous. But after that, like very slightly, I was nervous. But after that initial time of 5 minutes had gone by, I was very comfortable, sir.
Why you were nervous?
Sir, I knew this interview was do or die, sir, for me. Like, I knew if I do this interview well, I will be in. And if I don't do it well, then I will be out. Because I was having that feeling ki ye interview pe bahut kuch depend hoga. So, it was like a do or die situation for me, sir, when I had entered the hall.
So, you were fully energetic?
Yes, sir. I was fully energetic because I knew this is do or die. If I don't do well, I'll get rejected. I knew that.
Yeah, any advantage you got from, like, you visited their motivation room, sometime in the waiting hall itself, lot of information regarding aircraft, ships, or the decorated soldiers, so many things are there, the army weaponry, and in the, you had gone basically to this motivation hall, like any advantage, even for raising your morale or for motivation, like what was the advantage? Then you went to the reporting place almost 1 hour before the interview.
Yes, sir. That was very advantageous, sir. Because I knew ki matlab 3 baje niklunga to dimag mein rahega ki main sahi time pe pahunch raha hu ki nahi. So I wanted to reach the place early, sir. So when I reached the place early, I was very calm and composed, sir. Like before the interview, like there was no hadbad nahi hui ki I have to reach by 3. So our motivation room is also such that it is very quiet, sir. The motivation room in the AFSB center is very quiet and calm.
Yeah, nobody goes there.
Yeah, even if any, no one goes at that point of time, sir, in the morning.
Yeah, it has to be a very peaceful place and very totally there, neat and clean.
Totally neat and clean and peaceful, sir. So, thoda I got peace of mind, sir, before the interview.
Okay, what was the key factor which kept you fully motivated during your interview? You did not bog down in any manner.
Sir, generally, actually, I enjoy speaking during the interview, sir. Like, I like to give interviews, sir, because there is an interaction with an officer of the armed forces. So, actually, I like it, sir. I like that I am expressing my views and the interviewing officer is expressing his views. So, I enjoy the interview, sir. The interview, I enjoy it the most. And that is one thing which I look forward to, sir, during the SSB. So, like, initially, I was a bit nervous, but that goes, sir. After 5 or 6 minutes, it goes automatically. And it is important ki thoda you always put on a smiling face, sir. Even if he's putting you under pressure, even if smile is not coming, I put on a smile, sir. Ki forcefully I put on a smile, sir. As an ki
that's the key. So when you were getting up, like, what was your last conversation with the presiding officer, interviewing officer?
Last conversation was very good, sir. Actually, he told that he told in the interview at the end that it was a pleasure talking with young minded people like you, and you have a very bright future as you're good in academics. So that gave me the hint ki my interview has gone well, sir.
They are very smart to keep you motivated. Okay, very nice. They could see a bright future, they could see a bright officer in you. Yeah, but still SSB was not over. Then conference day.
Yes, sir. In conference.
Okay, 4th day you had a totally cushy day. You enjoyed.
Yes, sir. 4th day yes. Was free. Like
nothing. For everyone or for only you?
Like for our group. For our group it was free, sir.
Okay. Others had interview.
Others, yeah. Like there were 8 people among us, sir. 4 of them. They got their interviews finished on day 3, and the remaining three had interviews on the 5th day. Like in AFSB also on the 5th day, we have GTOs and interviews. And then the conference starts at the afternoon at 12. So I was like, my task, 4 of us got our task finished on day 3. Everyone had a off on day 4. Some of them had interviews on day 5.
And when was the conference on day 5?
Conference started at 12 p.m., sir.
Okay. So, when your turn came from conference, what was the atmosphere around among the candidates?
Actually, I was like in the initial batch itself, they had called me, sir. Pehle hi like conference, 40 people were there. So, 5-5 ki conference ho rahi thi. So, in the initial 5 students itself, my name had come, 25.
So 5 of you went together inside?
No, no. 5 of us were sitting in the conference room, sir.
Okay.
Sorry, in the waiting room.
Okay.
So after they had gone, after the 4 of them had gone, I knew ki agar thoda sa, if they are taking 4 or 5 minutes before calling me, that is a good sign. Kyunki generally, if they are not taking time, it is either they...
It's that side or that side.
Agar 4-5 minutes le rahe hain, toh it is a good thing, sir. So in my case, they were taking thoda sa unne time liya 4-5 minutes ka. Toh mereko samajh mein aa raha tha ki it is good. So but what happened was 4 of them had gone and the next 4 had come. So they were very like they were making a lot of noise and they were very excited. And I was the person who was waiting for my chance. So thoda I was also feeling a bit nervous, sir, before the conference, kyunki conference, like, it is very unpredictable, sir.
Fate is going to be sealed.
Yes, sir, fate is going to be sealed. So thoda I was a bit nervous, sir, ki kya hoga, kaisa hoga, and thoda इट वॉज देयर सर कि कैसे करना है. एंड देन आई एंटर्ड द कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम. तो व्हेन आई एंटर्ड द कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम दैट नर्वसनेस वॉज क्वाइट लेस कंपेयर्ड टू वॉट इट वॉज.
सच अ बिग टीम सिटिंग इन द चेयर एंड ओनली वन मैन स्टैंडिंग टू रिप्लाई.
यस सर, यस सर. तो थोड़ा व्हेन आई वेंट टू द कॉन्फ्रेंस आई वॉज चिल सर. उसके पहले आई वॉज अ बिट नर्वस. When I entered the room, then I got okay. Chalo, theek hai, I have reached. Kyunki you don't know which person is talking, who is the one talking. So they tell ki who is the one with the flag. He is the one who is talking. So you have to immediately identify him, sir. Ki he is the one. So I identified him. Ki he was sitting on my left side, sir, on towards the left side of the board president.
Your GTO was there. Who was telling ki I will be there in conference?
He was there, sir. He was also there, sir.
Okay.
He was also there, sir.
He has to be part of that.
Yes, sir. So, my conference, they asked me question related to my CGPA, sir. I had a good CGPA of 9.35. So, they asked, first question was, what is your CGPA? Then they asked, ki, ye CGPA, who will you give credit to for this CGPA? So I told my teachers, my friends and my parents. So they were like, would you not give yourself credit? So then I told ki apna like our hard work to hota hi hai, but jo support and credit hai, that is very important. Matlab, without support it's not possible. It's a collective effort of everyone. Then they asked me ki how did you keep yourself fit during the COVID pandemic? That was one thing which they asked. And then he asked ki, how was your stay? What and all did you do with your friends? And in the end, he asked me, how will I celebrate my birthday?
Is it close?
Yes, sir. It is on July 31st, sir. So he asked me ki, how will I celebrate my birthday? He asked me that, sir. So after that he left me, sir. He, okay, Spandan.
Okay, what was your answer when he said that how you maintain your physical fitness during COVID? What was your answer?
Sir, I told ki I was doing like I was wearing mask and I was going out for jogs daily, and gym also whenever it was open, I was going to the gym also, sir, whenever I got the opportunity. And those were the two ways in which I kept myself fit, I told, sir, during the pandemic.
Okay, wonderful. Any experience of other people, other candidates whom you like to reflect here for the benefit of others? Okay, finally, how many people got select recommended?
7 got recommended, sir, out of 40.
Out of 40.
Yeah, 150 out of 155, 40 screened in, 7 recommended, sir.
And in your batch, like your batch was 16?
In my batch, 8 people were there, sir. Out of that, I and one more chess number got, 2 people from our group got recommended, sir.
Okay, wonderful. And yes, you were saying something about the conference.
Conference, sir,
for the experience of other people, how others behave. Which clicked and or went against them or went in favor of them. Any observation you have got?
Sir, what, like over the SSB process, what observation which I made was ki people start judging others on the basis of GTO, sir. But actually it is not like that. GTO is the thing which is seen. But the psych and interview of the candidate involved, other candidate, you don't see it, ki how he has performed in psychological tests and interview. So it is people start judging on the basis of GTO. So it is better not to judge anyone on the basis of GTO, and you see, you, because you don't know how he has performed in the interview and psych. So that is one thing, because I feel sometimes people start thinking ki this fellow will not get recommended, or this person is not up to the mark, and at the end of the day he gets recommended, so they get surprised. So I would say that never underestimate anyone in the SSB. And what I learned is ki SSB is not a competitive exam, sir. It is like everyone is helping
it is
everyone.
It is a test of your personality and leadership.
Yes, sir. So it is better if you don't treat it as a competitive exam. Ki I have to defeat this fellow or I have to do better than him. It is like you are competing against your own self. So,
you will remember this lifetime achievement. I wish you good luck. I am very more than sure that you will be a very successful officer.
Thank you, sir. It is because of your guidance which has been possible, sir. Otherwise, it would have not been possible, sir. Tu chalta ja, tu chalta ja, tu chalta ja.